Well, cue the fire. I am announcing it right now. If you currently live in Deutschland, if you live in Germany, it is time to get out. If you live in New York City, it is time to get out. It is a war zone. Get out of Los Angeles, dumpster fire, and Pittsburgh. You could have the whole place wiped out. Well, actually, the report says all offices gone in less than 4 years. New York City district slammed as third world, as shocking video shows. It's what you voted for. Sorry. Oh, I got, we got Kate breaks cover. and in New York, you need to take cover. Look at this. This is insane. Actually, it looks like Los Angeles. So this video actually could be from Los Angeles. But as we have borders wide open, come on over, everyone. It's okay. It's all right. Come one, come all. And oh, we're going to the other side of the street. As if one side wasn't bad enough. Here you go. Swap meet? I don't know. Well, at least she's better safe than sorry. Look at this. This is insanity. And you know what? It's only going to get more worse. I was going to say trabajar. I think the correct pronunciation for worser in Spanish is America. No, it's peror. Did I say that right? Failed it. Sorry. Not too good. Actually, it's so bad. How bad is it, Bravo? Illegal immigrants politely decline free flight on Boeing. Also, how about that stock market? Holy moly, actually, Game of Trades taking out a short. Are you sure? Well, I mean, if you used any macro in any of this, everyone and their mother would be shorting this. As the S&P 500 and 10-year, the yield curve, you know how it inverts? Normally, the market and the curves, it all kind of flows together, and now we kind of have a divergence. I wouldn't say kind of, I would say you have a gnarly divergence. So if you were to right click and click short the S&P 500, I would not stop. I might pause you. As you know, Bravo no like taking short outs above the 200 in a rising wedge. Just thought, right? Maybe I said, if you guys, this was a few days ago, I'm like, if you guys want to do it, I mean, you did have your 7, 8, 9. Come on, purple nurple. Oh, one candle. Yep. Nope. Fakey. Oh, and just in case you want to see what I am currently trading, because now we have to just wait for the S&P 500 on the major indices on this channel. I like to do those just for basic. And then I do things like Google. Same thing, right? This is a falling wedge, bullish, different than a rising wedge. 7, 8, 9, put in a buy. This was in my watch list. How much you currently making on that snaky 80? You're up 87%. 1,200, well, 585 in the money. Almost 90%, maybe even higher today because I was looking at that yesterday. Also, if you want to learn how to do it, you know my watch list, so I'm not doing the free. One you just saw was options, but you got to start with swing trading first. Take advantage of my St. Paddy Day sale that was 24 hours. Looks like, looking at the clock, you have 3 hours left. And that is 80% off any course you want. Bull market swing trade course. Start there, then bear market. And then if you want to do some crypto, buy diapers and then do options. But try to get to options as fast as you can. I teach you how to do setups. Like, this is tough for me. This is like macro. As you know, I do lose my boo-ha-ha in my trades when I trade macro. Actually, I would have lost truckloads of money if ever since I was talking about an inverted yield curve, right? It's like, short this market. It's never been worse. This is like recession, depression time. Why market go up? Well, that's because you're above the 200. Actually, market went down today on 2,000 of your stocks. Actually, something even more boring on your 2,000 stocks. You're at the same level as you were in 2021. Look at this. Just farting around. Imagine how many hedge fund managers must be getting phone calls from you saying, the market go up. Why my accounts not go up? I mean, imagine how much money you might have been able to accumulate if you would have subscribed to my channel. Oh, the button's still there. Actually, if you push it, I think it like makes a really cool color. You subscribe and then you maybe listen to what I have to say. Like Bitcoin over the last, I don't know, it's 8 years where people laugh at me, or gold and silver like this, where people are like, oh, look at that relic. Still preaching the Peter Schiff. Well, actually, I've had him on the channel a few times. I even brought up the little Bitcoin and I said, careful what you say, Peter. It might come back to bite you in a tidal wave, right? Just Oh, wait, after the halving, now you'd probably dump and then whee. And I know 21 million, but there's also, you know, 21 million seashells, whatever. But like always, always be moving your money. And hopefully it's not in real estate, which I'm going to go into right now, because that's what we were talking about how it is coming. It's all crashing down from China to Germany to now 1 trillion in 2024 CRE maturities could lead to hundreds of bank failures, because it is all on their balance sheet, beautifully, just ripe for the picking. And I've done videos on this with fire, and I prepare you for the future. Now we are starting to enter said future. And I am not the only one who's talking about this. This is Bloomberg, it's all over. Commercial real estate, dumpster fire, but not yet. As Bloomberg Markets live reporter and strategist James details below, if defaults topple hundreds of U.S. banks, which, I mean, the Fed's kind of told you that's going to happen, so they don't look stupid. As the pessimists predict, the impact on markets and the economy will be, well, that's a big word, but I will help you with it, tumultuous. You have about $1 trillion coming on, well, right now, the next few months. And then $5 trillion and $10 trillion. I think it's about a $20 trillion industry. But if you say that this won't affect anything, okay. Again, I have no dog in this fight. I trade charts. I come to you bearing doom and gloom from these articles. Do I trade the way the articles are? I do not. But here's the facts. Fact number one. Yeah, border wide open. People crossing like crazy. These people, I would say, they're not really your Nordstrom's, Tiffany's, Bloomingdale's shoppers. They bring with them their baggage, and then they put it all over your streets. Which is fine, because culturally, that's where they come from. They seem to be destroying your cities, and it's not going to stop. Well, maybe around November, December, January, there might be some stopping. Anywho, default. What? San Francisco, Four Seasons. Do you see? It's a Four Seasons. I would love to go there. But it's a dumpster fire. Why is that, Johnny Bravo? Four Seasons Hotel investors, $3 million late on loan as foreclosure looms. Dump, dump, dump. I mean, look at Four Seasons. This is where you go if you want to spend a lot of money. This, Four Seasons. Kaput. I mean, you just couldn't pull it off, could you, San Francisco? Okay, I'll go here. And also, I don't want to pick on California, every city in the United States of America, being from Austin, not being from, I mean, over 50 years in California. So I got it. I'm like, I'm going to run over here to California. And then all of you made fun of me. You're like, you just left California. You went to California. Austin is California in Texas. It's like, what are you doing? And then I said, I am building. Actually, I'm in my studio right now. It's not good. I have wires everywhere. If you saw this, you'd be like, wow, you pulled it off. So I got a lot of fixing to do, but I am 1 hour outside of Austin. Where? What's going on in Austin? Once America's hottest housing market, Austin is running in reverse. So if you would like to pick up some property on the cheap, home prices have fallen more than anywhere in the United States of America. So I just do not want to be the kettle calling the pot black, or the stove, or the frog that is in the stove, or in the boiling water, because it's everywhere. Actually, I know where that's at. Actually, that's kind of interesting. It just dawned on me. I'm like, it's a plastic bag, but I'm like, I know that building. Austin too is a dumpster fire, because people try to do what's right, and they try to do what feels good, or I don't know, maybe following power or money. You know, it's sometimes confusing. Which one are you trying to do? Someone is a Republican, you know, trying to get votes one year, and then they're like, I'm switching. But for the most part, my liberal friends that live one street away from there, really kind hearts, also known as enabling, which I am not a proponent of. It's just like raising kids. The one that you treat the worst is probably going to grow up to be the best. But now back to the dumpster fire of a housing market everywhere. Germany too. I'll get you Germany. Half of downtown Pittsburgh office space could be empty in 4 years. Now think about this. Actually, don't think about it. Look at this. This is going to be every city in the United States of America. Try to explain how it's not. It's not. That doesn't look very safe over there. And in yesterday's video, I was talking about New York. how that's a gigantic dumpster fire. And I know we can all blame these guys, good old politicians, but in the end, it's power and money. I'm not going to throw dirt. All I'm going to do is say, you need to get out. There isn't a solution. We're also in a downturn. This is everything's going down. But markets went up. Anywho, delinquency rate of multifamily housing. Oh, highest since 2013. I'm going to go with that's not good. What happens after everyone vacates the big buildings, the houses, the cities? It gets really bad. You're just beginning to see the really bad in the cities, and then it's going to spread. It spreads outside the cities, and it gets to your beautiful little homes and your suburbs. But actually, it could hit there too. Look, people don't even feel like buying a home. I've been showing you this. Lowest since 1960. It's like, nope. It's like retail goes, right? This was Yelp said 50% during the pandemic. Government was able to eliminate 50% of businesses. So then it goes from businesses to commercial real estate. See how we all consolidate, right? The banks. Oh, banks are next. You have office spaces. And then banks and other countries, as now Germany is running out of money. Wow. And debt levels are exploding. That's us. Debt levels exploding. We haven't seen this amount of money disappearing. That's what happens in a tightening cycle. You need loans. Loans are currently not happening. So in a debt-based system, no loans, no money. This is 1929, 1930-ish. It's happening all over the world, from America to China to Germany, as building permit. Look at how's that? Building permits for dwellings. Let's give up. Already in Germany, they're just like, nope, forget it. Just to flush it. They are currently in a recession, though their politicians won't let them say it, right? Germany, probably in a recession. Well, looking at that, I'm going to say yes. Germany is in a recession. Are you sure, Bloomberg? Due to first quarter slump, survey shows. And actually, I would be shocked if we're not in one, if you really wanted to know the truth. I mean, look at your industrial production year over year. Every single time, except for one, just one, signal a recession. But I guess this time is different. 70, let's just count them. We got 70, we got 74. These gray vertical bars are recession, industrial production, what we are producing. Recession, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. 8 of the 9. Well, maybe they'll say, oh, we're okay. Biden's new plan to whatever he does fixes everything by fixing the numbers. You know how to do this? You even did it. And don't say that you didn't. And there's actually teachers that would give an F+. I'd say that was really mean. It's still zero. Why are you putting a plus? I'd see that on report cards. I'm like, that teacher's an idiot, but that is okay. But you all know how we fix that, right? We go home and we're like, look, Dad, A+. Actually, I had students that I hired, because those were the smart ones, that actually had full-blown software programs, or the parent would log in, or they think they would log in to the grade portal, and the kids would change the grades and be like, look, I'm doing great. That is a true story. I did hire one kid. He was a software genius. You know the kind. Out of high school, made more money than, out of high school, he made 3 times as much as I did as a high school teacher. Not as much as I made in my businesses. That's different. Anyways, here's our economy, which you guys are going to give me a tough time on this one. We have Suez Canal. Got it right. I said Suez right. Suez Canal traffic has dropped 50%. That is stuff coming to you. Those are ships carrying your stoof. So if you were to tell me everything's going great, I'm going to say no. Well, look at the stock market. Okay, look at the stock market. That's okay, because I trade it. But yet macro, you macro channels out there, you got this one pat. I just do my best to come on this channel and say, don't confuse that with this, and don't confuse the stock market with the economy, and don't choose, or also don't look at your wages, because that's not doing too well, and the United States are falling at a striking pace. Wow, you mean what you're telling me, what I've been saying for the last umpteen years, the top 1% are going to own everything? The answer is ding, 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 yes. The top 1%, they don't care about wages. They make their own wages by selling things like this. Actually, this one looks very interesting. Sorry, I need to look. Hey, any of my kids that are watching my channel, which you don't, buy me one of these for my desk. I do not know why we have a parakeet. Do I get the bird too? Actually, you want to know how much he makes? Tabletop bowling game. I was thinking 15 grand. What do we got? Oh, 12 grand. Not bad. Okay. Good job, Dad. Also, take advantage of my sale on my Amazon course. $99. Will never go lower than that. I would have to be an idiot, which I am. So fix your wage falling and building someone else's dream. Build your own. I don't care what you do. I just have to come here and give you solutions. Whatever you want to do. I may even do a course on how to start a window washing business. I don't think that one will do too well. But maybe it will be 20 different or 10 different businesses how to start. If you think I should, comment in the link in the description. Now you're just freaking me out if you really say yes that I actually have to do it, because my digit's already up. Need no more businesses because I've been starting a new business every single year of my life since I was probably 9, selling mistletoe. Honest to goodness, truth, allocations, and doing this in U.S. stocks, highest level since 2001. That's why I'm like saying, be ready for rug pull. That doesn't mean try to find this top, right? Oh, that's just so painful unless you trade options. Then you could do that. So I'm hoping GOAT is doing options, because just also to let you know, on a short trade, the pain is endless. Because as you know, you're like, I bet you it's going to go down, but it goes up. How high can it go up? It could go up forever. For me, I would just rather trade patterns. Get in, get out. Get in, get out. And have like my stuff. You know, 9 count comes on. Purple nurple. Write it. 88%. Move on. Do another one. Anywho, you guys, I love you. Get out of the cities or learn to move. Always be moving. In motion, right? Money in motion. Your body in motion. Motion rhymes with lotion, so you should sell lotion on Amazon. And I love you. I'll see you tomorrow.